in the vector addition and subtraction after completing the commutative and distributive. Again, if you come here, the second law, which is the associative law. Associative law means check with three numbers, with three vectors. Okay, how sir? Right, very simple. Sometimes we see in arithmetic. Okay, yeah, exactly. Not A into, this is like Deepika, A plus B plus C, addition, we take like this, A plus B plus, right. So 2 plus, suppose 3 plus 4, if I ask, then you can say 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 2, 9. That you can write like 2 plus 3 is added to 4. Like 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 4, again 9. This is valid law, valid law in numbers, mathematics. Okay, this kind of writing the three numbers like is called as associative law. The same associative law is applicable, applicable for the vectors or not. For scalars, it is applicable. For numbers, it is applicable. Yeah. Yes, exactly. Exactly. That we have to say here. Okay. So if you see there, for the given three vectors, here we are taking 3. If I write A bar plus added to B bar and C bar. Suppose if you are able to prove this is equal to A bar plus B bar, first these two are added and that is added to finally to C bar. If you are able to prove, then I can put here is equal to. Okay. This is associative law. Whether this associative law is valid or not. Of course, we can say it is true, but here just using the diagram, we try to prove it. Okay. First, I take this is A bar. And this is the red one is B bar. And suppose the blue one is C bar. All the three are taken in order. A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Okay. That one, first what you are taking, sir, I have to add A bar plus B bar first. And that should be added to C. So first I take here, till here better I take a dotted one. Okay. Here A bar plus B bar, A bar plus B bar, I am taking like this. This is A bar plus B bar, the green one. Okay. First I took right hand side, I think. Okay, no problem. First, I'm checking the right-hand side now, that A bar plus B bar is added to C bar. So A bar plus B bar plus C bar means it is the initial point. It is the final point. I have to join them like here. This time I can take the solid line. This is nothing but the black one is A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Okay. Here only we should get A bar plus B bar plus C bar also. Okay. So first you start from B bar plus C bar. Now start from here. B bar plus C bar. Look at there what I am drawing. B bar plus C bar. I'm going to join these two points with a dotted line like this. Okay, with a dotted one. This is what this orange color is B bar plus C bar. B bar is added with C bar. Okay. That orange one is added to A bar. So in continuation, A bar plus this time B bar plus C bar, almost looking like vertical line. Okay. Look at this is the initial point. That is the final point. I think I am getting along the same line. Okay. Better I take another color. Okay, I go with this color. All right. Look at this one, Nana. A bar plus B bar plus C bar means from here I'm going to draw like this. Okay, for distinction, we are, yeah, just a bit down I'm drawing here or bit up, whatever. Okay. All right. Look at there, Nana. Who is this? This is A bar plus B bar that is added with the C bar. Both you are getting in the same direction of same length. Yeah, along the black line, exactly. Okay. Along the black line, I am getting same direction, same length, same magnitude, same direction. So finally, I conclude here. Yeah, therefore, yes, A bar plus B bar plus C bar is equals to A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Okay, if A bar, this condition is satisfied, then the addition of vectors. Obeys that addition of vectors obeys the associative law. This is called associative law. Then will we check whether it obeys the subtraction of vectors also obeys the associative law or not? Okay, check here. Here also I am going to write it is associative law. And this time I am taking not addition, subtraction. Okay, for the given three vectors. Is it possible, Nana? Once you check 2 minus 3 minus 4, is it equal to 2 minus 3 minus 4? No, I think, yeah, exactly. Yeah. 2 minus 3 is actually minus 1. Minus 1 minus 4 is minus 5. Not possible. This is 2 minus 3 minus 4 is actually minus 1. I'm getting 3, 2 plus 3. 2 plus 1, that is 3. Just numbers itself, they are not obeying the associative law. Means the scalars itself, they are not obeying the associative law. So I don't think it's so. It does not obey the associative law. Will you accept? Numbers itself, they are not obeying means I think it is a mere waste of time checking that one. Okay, yes, mere waste. Here directly we can write, yeah, exactly, directly we can write for the given three vectors without checking, I think, vectors. A bar, directly we can write. Why? Because we know A bar minus B bar minus C bar is not equal to A bar minus B bar minus C bar. Thus, it does not obey. Okay. It does not obey the associative law. Is it to be verified, Nana? Is it required? Once you say, no need. Okay, right, good. Right. So here, once you cross-check all the three laws, Nana, all the three laws here valid in addition, only the last law means third one. Actually, this is second one. The third one, distributive law is obeyed by the subtraction of vectors. Remaining commutative and associative, both are not valid in subtraction of vectors. us. Yes, both associative and distributive. So after coming to here, the conclusion of the loss of vectors, finally, I'm writing here. Final conclusion. From the loss of vectors of addition, from the loss of vectors of subtraction, from both, what is the conclusion? The addition of vectors obeys all the three laws or only one law, Nana? Addition of vectors? Yeah, all the three laws. Addition of vectors obeys all the three laws. Yes, exactly. All the three laws. Okay. Whereas here conclusion, the subtraction of vectors. Yeah, not first law, I think, Deepika, third law. The subtraction of vectors. Obeys only the third law. Better I write instead of first law, second law, third law. Better I write the name. Obeys only the distributive law. Yes, that is better. Oh, one law. Nah? Okay, not first law. Okay, right. Only the distributive law. Yes. So by this we completed even simultaneously the IP part, get the loss of vectors and explain the loss of vectors. It is a question. Again, if you have any subject to type of exam, like previously what you wrote, okay, you can read this question. Loss of addition, loss of subtraction, both are completed. Okay, and here, from this addition and from the subtraction, what kind of applications will be there? From addition, already by using the parallelogram law of vectors, I gave few examples. I think yesterday we focused more on the applications, yesterday and day before. Okay, how to use the parallelogram law of vectors. Right, a few applications I gave. Applications means few examples I gave. And here, in addition to that, okay, those applications, if you see few more, sometimes simply we can say the answer like this. Suppose these are two vectors not given by taking them at one point, means like originating from the same point. But he gave them in order like this. Look at there, in order. Then here what he says, these two vectors suppose make an angle that theta, that theta is not equal to 0 degrees and not equal to 180 degrees. Means I think you understood. Not equal to 0 means they are not parallel. Not equal to 180 degrees means they are not anti-parallel. Anti-parallel means opposite direction. Okay. Anti-parallel, here angle is 180 degrees. Parallel means here angle is 0 degrees. Now you follow, Nana? Not 0 degrees, not 180 degrees. Then how much is this angle, sir? Maybe acute, maybe obtuse, maybe right angle. So simply I'm writing theta lies in between. Exactly, I'm going to write the same pranav. Theta lies in between 0 degrees and 180 degrees. Okay, I'm not writing here equal to, if I'm not writing here equal. So lies in between 0 and 180. Then look at there. In such a case, okay, surely the resultant looks like the third open side of a triangle. Surely it forms a triangle. Am I right? Triangle. Okay. If you construct a parallelogram, that is a diagonal. Yes, accepted, accepted. But if you don't construct that parallelogram, then the third side, open side, okay, gives the resultant vector. Shall I say like this? The third open side here, this one. Okay, resultant, how to take? No need to explain. All of you know it. We have to take the result. Oh, it is blue color. Okay, right. Come to here like this. This is the resultant of A and B. That to taken in order, there is no reverse order. So it is equals to A bar plus B bar. Is it right, Nana? Without constructing a parallelogram, with a triangle, if you say the resultant, the open side, okay? These two are the two adjacent sides of a triangle taken in order. The open side gives you the resultant vector, okay? Once you see the statement, this is actually called as, in such a case, the triangle law of vectors, Nana. Triangle law of vectors. What is this triangle law, sir? Happily, if the angle lies in between 0 and 180, I can take the given two vectors as the adjacent sides. So I am going to write the same, the given two vectors are taken as the adjacent sides of a triangle, but take care, taken in order, comma, taken in order. We should not place them like originating from the same point. Okay, not like this. This is also forming a triangle, Nana, if I don't construct a parallelogram. Okay, but you should not take like this. It is wrong. You have to take in order. Means like this, in order. Yeah. Shift parallel. Very good. Shift parallel. Okay, don't take like this. Take like this, in order. Then, in order, taken in order, then I'm going to write here. The open side means the third one after constructing with these two vectors, A bar and B bar. Okay, then the third side is obviously open. Why? Because I took only two vectors, the open side here, this one. Okay, gives the resultant vector, the dotted one, what I have shown on the other side. Okay, then the open side gives the resultant vector of course both in magnitude and direction, okay, but observe there I took this dotted one in the upward direction. Means look at A and B are arranged in order in anti-clockwise direction. Am I right? If you see like the directions, not a clock and anti-clockwise direction. But this one is not in anti-clockwise direction. Look at there. It is in clockwise direction. Is it correct? The resultant vector, dotted one, is in clockwise. Yeah, the resultant is in clockwise. That's why here, if these two are arranged in anti-clockwise, the resultant I am finding out not in the same order, taken in reverse order. Shall I say like this, Nana? In opposite order, exactly. In opposite order, reverse order. Shall I say? Okay. The opposites are the open side gives the resultant vector, but in opposite order, that is reverse order. Okay, this is the triangle of vectors. Why should I learn this triangle of vectors, sir? Already I learned the parallelogram law. From parallelogram law, I can extract anything, sir. Very good question. Okay, here, look at the example. You can understand the advantage of learning the triangle of vectors. Suppose two vectors are given like this, Nana. This is one vector. And this is another, this is another vector. Yeah, I perfectly arranged. Both are taken in order. And A bar has the magnitude like 6 meters. This is mod of A bar. And mod of B bar, magnitude of this one, length of this side is also 6 meters. Okay, or simply here he said mod B bar is equals to mod A bar. Their magnitudes are equal. And the angle he said here, not in like in parallelogram. In parallelogram, we have to take the angle when they are originated from the same point. Okay, so not that angle. When they are taken in order, the angle between them is 60 degrees. Then what is the magnitude and direction of resultant if they ask? That's what I'm saying. Directly I say using the triangle of vectors. Oh, they are taken in order. The open side gives the resultant vector. Okay. These two are equal. Angle is 60 means surely it forms a right angle. Equilateral triangle. Equilateral triangle means why should I use the parallelogram of vectors? Directly I say magnitude of resultant is also equals to 6 meters. Yeah, is also equals to 6 meters. Why? Because it is an equilateral triangle. And the angle made with the A bar without using the formula tan alpha is equals to B sin theta by A plus B cos theta. Directly I say it makes an angle 60 degrees with A bar. Yes, yes. All of you followed this example, Nana? Yes. Okay, that's what I'm going to write here. Without the help of parallelogram law of vectors. Without using the parallelogram law of vectors. Okay, anyone can say the magnitude and direction, both, anyone, not only the master, even any student can say here in the class, the magnitude and direction of the resultant vector. Am I right, Nana? Even you also can't say without my help. Okay. Are you able to say or not? Without my help. Able to say, yes, exactly. Magnitude and direction of the resultant vector. Sir, this time you won't explain, sir. We say the answer, sir. Sure. Look at this example. You only try. Suppose this is one example I am taking here, whether you are able to say, just cross-checking. This time I am taking. It is one vector, A bar. Is it visible, Nana, this color? Yeah, okay. Mod A bar equals to 3 eta. And taken the other vector in order like this. Yes, yes, in order. You take it like this. This is mod B bar equals to 4. And the angle is 90 degrees. How much you say and what is the direction? Sure, Nana. Next time we'll use the dark colors only. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. The resultant is the open side taken not in order. Reverse order we have to take. Okay. We should not take it down opposite. Yeah, resultant without using the parallelogram, anybody can say mod of this resultant equals to 5. Why? Because it is a right angle triangle, 3, 4 are the sides, 3, 4, 5 right angle triangle. Anybody can say here what will be the angle made with Nana? Alpha is equals to 53. Anyone used the parallelogram law of rectas here? No, directly you said without the help of parallelogram. Directly by using the triangles law, even we set the direction also upwards, not downwards. Without constructing. Yeah, 4 by 3. That 4 by 3 is 53 degrees, Harsha. Okay, 53 degrees. See here, this is another example. Okay, right, that's it over. So, this is one added advantage by knowing the triangle law of vectors. Right? And sometimes, we have one more advantage with the triangle law of vectors. What is the additional advantage for us, sir? Simple. In triangle law, whereas in the case one, I took two vectors now. This time, I'm taking three vectors. How, sir? Triangle has three sides now. So I'm taking three vectors here. Like one, Oi, Harsha bhai. What, Harsha bhai? What happened today? This is in order. These two are taken in order. Okay? Means in anti-clockwise. Look at the resultant is taken in anti-clockwise. Means downwards or upwards. The resultant. Clockwise means that is taken in opposite order or not? Opposite to this order. Which order? Arranging the two vectors. Two vectors are arranged like this. This is the order of arranging. If you place the resultant also like this, then I say, resultant is also placed in the same order. But the resultant we are taking like this now, it is wrong now. So you are taking in opposite order or not? Now you followed, Mr. Harsha bhai? Right. That's why I said not taken in the same order. I said here in opposite order. Opposite means reverse order. Welcome. Right. Good. Then coming back to here. Right. Suppose this time I'm taking three vectors, A bar, not two vectors. Okay, like in the case one. This is another case. Three vectors I am taking. One, this is the second one. This is B bar. And the third one is also taken. Now I think you can understand, Harsha. Third one is also taken in the same order as the third side. In the same order. Now you understood this same order. Same order, going, everything is going in anti-clockwise. Yes, exactly, Srinidhi Priya, no need to put the question mark. You are right. Okay, right. So these are the three vectors here. A bar, and this is B bar, and this is C bar. This time I took the three vectors in order, closing the triangle, keep in mind, closing the triangle means actually we started from here, finally we reach to there. Okay, Srinidhi Priya identified the answer for the resultant. Any others identify? If it reaches to the same point, Wow, Srivatsa, good, correct? Still others? Yes, what happened to this city? Emaindi Nagaraniki. Mr. Balaji not responding. Siri not responding. Shashank not responding. Vaishnavi, long back I saw her here. Aditya not responding. Charanjit also stopped responding. Deepika this time not responded. Their magnitudes are not equal. Unequal, but forms an equilateral, sorry, not an equilateral angle, forms a triangle, closer to triangle, that I can give, that I can assure. Surya Samhita. Harsha, you are right. Others, you can say it, you can say. So every day before starting the class, I think we have to start the ad, like in movies. No, Ray Deepika. Suppose a body is projected vertically upwards and reaches to the same point, then how much you say the displacement, Deepika? Then why you are not able to say here? It reaches to the same point. It reaches to the same point means what will be the resultant? This time, one by one. Now you started saying the answers. Very good. This time response. That is the response I'm expecting. Yes, exactly. All of you predicted that is correct. Why? Because reach to the same point. Means zero. That is simply. Resultant is zero. Zero means in basic maths, I said there, it is a null vector. Anyone remember? The vector having the magnitude zero. Yes, yes. So I am going to introduce the null vector here. Yes. So I am going to write there the same thing. If three vectors, not two vectors, having the same magnitude or unequal mass, it means equal magnitude or unequal magnitude, okay, that we don't know, just three vectors. Even you can arrange like this, three vectors. Okay, so here you can clearly say their magnitudes are not equal. Okay, so maybe arrange like this, but in order that you don't forget. Okay, the three vectors are arranged in order, all the three are taken in order, in continuation, okay? In order, as the sides of a closed triangle, this one also you should not forget, closed triangle. Sir, we did not follow this point properly. Why you are insisting it is a closed triangle, sir? Students are very smart, Nana. Papa, you are very good student, Ra, all of you. That's why you are not asking the questions. Students sometimes, they simply throw the questions like this. Sir, one vector is taken like this, sir. You said three vectors to be taken there. Yes, I took the three vectors like this, sir. This is the second vector. This is the third vector. Aray, you did not extend up to here, Ra, Ra. You did not tell, Na, sir. You placed the three vectors as the three sides of a triangle, and that too you said arrange in order. Yes, I arranged in order. What is the difference between these two, Nana? Is it a closed triangle? What the student asked? Papa, you are all good students, Ra. Papa, not asking any doubts here. Okay, so A bar, B bar, C bar. Here, suppose I arrange it like this. Sir, you did not say, sir, closed triangle, I arrange it like this. Sir, it is your mistake, sir. Simply, they point out. Okay? That's why I'm taking my care here, my utmost care here. Okay? So, as the sides of Clearly, I'm saying it is a closed triangle, not open triangle. Okay, in order and closed triangle, then you can say, then the resultant of three vectors, all are taken in order, so there is no subtraction, three vectors, you can say like A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Sorry, I have to write A bar plus B bar plus C bar or A bar plus B bar plus C bar, sir. Or A, no need to ask, already we proved it obeys the associative law. Both are same, ra. Already we proved here. Yes, sir. That's why you explained previously associative law, sir. Yes, Nana, to avoid such type of questions here. Okay, I understood, sir, why you explained the associative law. A bar plus B bar plus C bar here. Okay, taken. That's, or then the resultant of three vectors is, now I am introducing one hidden fellow. That hidden fellow is null vector. Better writing another color. Is null vector. I strongly believe that no one will ask here what is meant by null vector. Why? Because all of you know. Okay? Right. So that implies I write here R bar equals to, which is A bar plus B bar plus C bar, whose magnitude is zero. How to represent, I think I said there in that class, like O bar. Okay? It is a null vector whose magnitude is O, means zero. Right. Okay. This is the way how to say another closed triangle, open triangle. Both I explained. Sir, you only created one doubt in our mind, sir. Are I created one doubt in your mind, ra? Yes, sir, you only created one doubt. What the doubt I created unnecessarily? Sir, you said all we are good students, sir. If we are not good, generally we ask this kind of question. Okay, the third one is not closed properly. It is taken like this, the third one. Okay, this is A bar and this is B bar. Of course, this is C bar. From the above explanation, we understood one point, sir. It is not a closed triangle. If it is not a closed triangle, A bar plus joint. Exactly, Srinidhitriya. You are right. A bar plus B bar plus C bar, since it is not closed, confidently we can say it is not equal to O bar. Am I right, Nana? Confidently you can say. Why? Because it is not closed. Yes. Still opened. When it is opened, how to say the answer? Already I said, na? Join the tail, join the head with arrowhead. Okay? This is the open triangle. So here, open triangle, where it is opened, here it is opened. Join the tail, join the head with arrowhead, like this. It is the result. So all of you followed, Nana, this one? Do you have still any doubt from the student's question? The student asked this question? Yeah, good. That is, right, very good. Here I write, this is the resultant, the green one is resultant, it is R bar this time, okay? Not equals to zero, and R bar is equals to, simply I say, you can write it as a null vector, Nana, no need to ask. Exactly. That is possible only when it forms a closed shape, any closed shape with two vectors or three vectors, triangle, more than three vectors, say polygon, like a square or rectangle or parallelogram or pentagon or hexagon, any shape. If it is closed, then the resultant is zero. And if yes, if you get zero directly, you can say it is a closed shape. Okay, good. So here R bar equals to A bar plus B bar plus C bar. Then use the parallelogram or triangle law vectors to find out the resultant. Again, don't ask how to find the resultant. First, to find out the resultant of A bar plus B bar, you will get like this, resultant of A bar plus B bar. Okay, C bar is quite in opposite direction, subtract that part to get R bar. Okay, Nana? Understood how to find? Yes, good, good, good. This is the way how to find the resultant, even though smartly if you ask the question like this. Okay, and here like all vectors incomplete, how to form a shape, Bharudai, Pranab? He supposes the second vector is given like this. First of all, I said what? The given two vectors, you have to take in order. In order means you have to take from here. Now you understood? Pranav is asking that all the three vectors are incomplete like this, sir. How to find? You have to place them. Right. Shift parallelly. Very good. Right? Then coming to here. If more than three vectors are given, sir, then it is called as more than three, na? Then you can't arrange them as a triangle. So you have to go to the other shapes with four sides, five sides, six sides, many polygon. Okay, that's why the same triangle law of vectors, we call it as polygon law of vectors. Polygon means here you may take more than three sides here. Okay, then that time how to find right the resultant vector? Then simple, in the same way you can see, suppose the polygon is formed the given vector, better I write like this, same Srini Ripa, exactly. The given, if you understand it properly, actually no need to explain the polygon law. You can understand. Okay. The given, suppose n minus 1 number of vectors are arranged as the sides, better as, as the sides of a polygon with n sides, polygon of n sides. Actually, that polygon has n sides. But you are not placing n vectors, you are placing n minus 1 vector. Means keep in mind one side is opened, means it is open polygon law. Okay, are arranged as the sides of a polygon of n sides. Then the open side, better, I forgot writing here, in order, Nana. Oh, this is very important, in order, then the open side gives, what the resultant vector. That resultant in case of open, always in reverse order. Resultant vector, but in reverse order. Do you have any doubt in this statement, Nana? Polygon law of vectors? Do you need a diagram for it? No one is responding. Srinidhi Priya responded. Do you need a diagram for this? Once you read the statement and ask? No. Mukunda Priya. Oh, who is this Mukunda Priya? Okay. Today only I am seeing you run. Glad to meet you. Surya Samita, okay, knows. No need. Okay, right. Harsha, he went off. Oh, many already went off. Oh, they don't want class, they want that time. Okay, right. No need, right. Pranav, okay, Nana, no problem. It's already 11:01. I will show the diagram for it tomorrow. Okay, Nana? Tomorrow means in the next class. Okay, Nana, Arsha, okay. Right, I will show the diagram for this in the next class. Okay, do you want the pages? I'm going to stop the class here.